If you want to last your shoes like a pro, like a real shoemaker, there are two lines you must know. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So, let's start! Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. Let's say you made a pattern, you finished sewing, and now you are in the process of lasting. And let's say you have the pattern like this, or maybe pattern of the flat ballet shoes, or any other, or high heel pumps, any other pattern that you have, you are now in the process of lasting. So how to place your upper correctly on the shoelace? Where to place? For example, in the pattern like this, it's very important to place it on the right place, because you don't have here any marks to know how to place it. But there are differences between outer side and inner side in your pattern, so it must lay on the right place. Okay, so where to put it? You see how to place it? Here, or maybe here. You know that we have a central line that divides our pattern on two parts. We have central line in the front of our pattern and in the back of our pattern. And you have the central line on your pattern. And the reason why you mark point on the upper, if you mark, of course, is the reason, is one of the important reasons to place your shoe upper correctly on the shoe last. But still, let's say you have this mark. Now, how to place it? How you will know that you place it on the right place? Yes, if you're already experienced shoemaker, you will find this place by eyes on your shoe last. But if you are a total beginner, it will be very hard for you to find this place correctly on the shoe last, and especially to do the same thing on both halves of your shoe last. So that's why here on the shoe last, these two important lines, like front central line and back central line with the mark of the back height heel, will help you a lot in lasting of your uppers. And following these lines, you will be able to last your uppers correctly on both halves of the shoe last, no matter what type of the footwear you are working on. Okay, so how to do it? Yes, I talked a lot about central pattern, and I made a video how to find central line on the shoe last. But this is not it. This is only in the beginning. When you will make a pattern, you should find the central line correctly on the shoe last, then you will have it on your pattern. But you will continue working with these central lines through the entire work, the entire process of shoemaking. So even after you will make correct central pattern on your shoe, on your shoe pattern, you still should find it again on your shoe last to be able to last it correctly. So because you see here, we don't have any reference to place our upper correctly. That's why we need to create them by ourselves. So how to do it? It's very important, but it's very simple, but very important in making almost any footwear type, like moccasins, for example. You see, in moccasins, we will follow with this border the edge of the shoe last, because in moccasins, for example, in this type of moccasins, there is a difference between inner side and outer side. The shoe last has asymmetrical edge. So by following this asymmetrical edge with this seam, we can place it correctly. But still, if we will have here central line on the shoe last, and we will have a mark of the center line on our upper, it will help us a lot to place our shoe upper correctly in the right place. Also, the back height is very important, because when you start to last, you start lasting from the back part, And that's why you should place it correctly on the back part of your shoe last. In making pattern, we should find this height according to the shoe size that you work with. And I also made a video about this approach, how to find it, how to measure it. And I will place a link to this video below the tutorial, okay? So you did it on your shoe pattern, now you should repeat it on your shoe last, and that's why this is how you will have these two important references on your shoe last to last your uppers correctly. So it's not only important in moccasins, it's also important in derby shoes. Here we have a center line that must match the center line of our shoe last. Okay, so spend too much time to find your center line again on the shoe last, let's mark it on the shoe last. For example, in some shoe last we can have it. For example, you see here is the center line here, and also I have on this shoe last the mark of the back height. But in most of the last shoe last you will not have it. You see, I don't have it here in any place, and I don't have any central line on the front and on the back on this shoe last. So we need to create it. And here is an example how to do it. You can do it with a piece of strap or masking tape with the central line on it, mark the center line, and also measure the needed back height of this shoe last size. Make the center line here on the back and put it on the measure on the height of the back that you should follow working with this shoe last size. For example, for size 38, the height of the back part is 55 millimeters. So to not measure it each time when you start to last your new pair, make a mark with a permanent mark or with masking tape. For example, you see it's old piece of masking tape, I used it a lot, and I also mark it because by eyes I can find the right measurement. So I measure it once, attach the piece of masking tape in the needed place in the distance of 55 millimeters from the edge of the shoe last, and to be sure that I always in the central line of my back part, I cut here this masking tape along the central line of the shoe last. Same thing here, I already marked here central line, but and right now I will not explain how to find the central line because I think I made a few tutorials about central line, you know, because this line is very important, you know, not only in the lasting and in assembly of your parts of the upper. If you want to have beautiful shoes, especially in palms, it's very important to find this line correctly, because you see this, for example, pattern of the palms with high heel, it has difference between outer side and inner side. It looks asymmetrical right now, you see this part is higher than the outer side part, and it's very important to place it in the right way on the shoe last, so at the end here you will have beautiful thwart line where everything is on the right place. It will not bother your feet, you will not see the edges of your toes in the beginning of your toes. Maybe you like it, but I personally don't like. I think it's very ugly, and in my shoes I cover the beginning of the toes. So it's very important to have the central line in any footwear type. So just to have this line always on your shoe last, you can mark with marker or attach a strap of masking tape along central part of your shoe last, and then find it and mark with the pencil central line. I will not find it right now, I will not measure it I have a tutorial how to do it, okay? So at the end, you will have the central line on the shoe last. You will have the exact measurements of the back height that you should follow during lacing. And this is how you will get your uppers. This is how you will last your shoe upper correctly on the shoe last. It's even important before lacing when you check your shoe patterns. For example, what I teach all my students that it's the better way to check your pattern is to check it from paper. And we make paper pattern like this, you see, and then we check it on the shoe last. So when we place this paper pattern, we also follow same steps that we will follow also later in the lasting process. We start from the back part and we should place our paper pattern and then real upper in the right place, and that's why we have right now the center line of the back, and the center line must match the center line of the paper pattern, and I have the right place, right mark where I need to place the edge of the paper pattern. Okay, so when you place your upper or paper pattern in the right place in the back, you will form it with nail, and then proceed to last your paper pattern or leather upper in the front. And now you see, I need to complete it more. And now it's very easy to place your paper pattern or leather upper in the right place in front of your shoe last, because now you see very precisely how to place it in the way where central paper pattern will match the central line that we marked on our shoe last. And this is how you will work in making your shoes, in the checking your paper pattern, or in the lasting process. Okay, so mark these lines, they will be permanent lines for the shoe last, so you don't need to find them each time from the beginning. The front central line, the right height on the back part of your shoe last, and when you do it, you will last your shoe uppers like professional. You will have beautiful and comfortable shoes. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come. Thank you again and see you in the next video. Bye.